We got a mind, but we don't know how to tap into this mode. Now we know. And this brings about the connection between all the parts of the brain, which also concerns disease.
Absolutely.
And depression. The glands, the pineal gland, the pituitary gland, and the hypothalamus. And we got it. So it's so simple and so effective.
Yeah, for the relevance for diseases. So if you just think about the cold itself increases norepinephrine, which is used to treat ADHD. It's used to treat depression. They're giving norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors to treat that, which have all sorts of side effects. And then the breathing increases the epinephrine, which then causes all the anti-inflammatory response.
Say that again. It's very interesting.
And I love so this then couple the two, you're talking about increasing
the
focus.
Epinephrine.
The norepinephrine is increased by the cold.
Yes.
And then the breathing, the controlled breathing increases the epinephrine and the adrenaline, which then causes all the anti-inflammatory response and then it decreases carbon dioxide, which then stops the pain.
So you're no speculation.
Yeah. So what you're talking about potentially, and this is what I'm interested in, is treating possibly depression.
Yes.
Anxiety, OCD.
Look at how serious this is. This is, and I want a science to back it up. Please help me with the scientific research. We got it, but we need to prove it.
You're doing a pretty good job. Right now, you've got two pretty good publications. One of them in the PNAS journal, which is a very nice journal. It's a great paper. You know, I read it two times. I think that you're on the right path to, you know, using science and harnessing the power of science to show the physiological changes, the brain changes that are occurring through the use of the cold, you know, shock, through the use of these breathing techniques.
You're very humble. She's a humble girl.
Thank
you. Nice.